Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Today's topic is relating to the management or the culture in the organizations, maybe in the society, or we can say that large families as well. Actually, a few days before, I posted on Facebook some of my ideas, and it was that never disappoint over the success of the opportunists and the cheaters. You will be sad for a certain time, but they will regret and suffer forever. So everything has a time to happen. Be patient. Then we have a family friend from Bangladesh, and she is a keen follower of my posts. She started discussing that such people, they are really powerful in the corporate world. Even if after they are caught by doing bad things, they leave the organizations, or they're made to leave the organizations, they become more powerful and they do unethical things. Then my response was that let us be positive, and apparently it seems that such people have become successful, but in reality this is not the case, because they have their own suffering which they may not be able to tell to the people. But let me tell you that they are not at peace, because if you are creating a problem and unrest into the lives of other people, you cannot be really at peace in your own life. So I thought that okay, I will share some of my ideas through this video, that how to handle certain situations when you come across due to such people. You must have heard about the 80-20 principle, whereby it is understood that 80% of the outcomes are the result of 20% of the input, or 80% of the results in the organizations are due to the efforts of 20% of the people who work hard, who really are focused, who are visionary. So I think this principle or this rule tells us a lot, that if we are really hardworking, we are focused, and we are really methodical in our approach, we have to be then, you know, very patient, very perseverant, and we have to ignore sometimes such people, their small, you know, bad things, in order to achieve the bigger goals. So I have few tips that I would like to share here, and this is the result of my own experience at personal and professional level. At professional level, when I was doing corporate jobs, and now I am working as an entrepreneur. I have my own, you know, setbacks and failures. I have own, you know, issues and problems that I faced due to the people. But I would like to share the tips. First is that please have a trust and faith and confidence in yourself, that you can withstand any negative situation, any pressure. Then have a faith in Allah Almighty, that He is there to help you out if you are standing on the truth. Because Allah has His own scheme of things. He has His own way to make things happen on the earth and into the lives of the people. So if you are really right and you are on the right path, so you leave things to Him, and He will be doing right things for you. This faith should be there. Second, don't think too much about small things happening around you, because this world is not an ideal place. You have to live with the reality where good and bad people, they are living together, they are working together, and their efforts and their deeds will have different outcomes. So we should try to live into such people, so that we could be able to survive, and we try to reform things when we are living together. Another idea is that try to integrate yourself into the team. Have strong peer-to-peer relationship. Because peer-to-peer relationship will help you create a circle of like-minded people, and it is how you will gain more strength intellectually and otherwise to handle and to tackle such people. The other point is that you should not be too much worried about such people, because if you are really confident, if you are really truthful, and if you are really positive, simple in your approach, you will automatically find support and strength for yourself. Another point is that don't consider yourself that, okay, you are really too much on the right path, you are important, and it is how you will be, putting yourself into a position that you are being excluded. So remain inclusive and try to have a meticulous and careful approach in your relationships. In the end, I would just like to say that that this world is a very strange world, where many things happen in your life which are really not predictable, but you have to handle those, because here your faith comes. Your real strength is your faith in yourself and in the God Almighty. And if this combination is there, I am sure that you will be really successful to handle such people, to handle such situations, and to be more happy, successful, and peaceful in your life. I hope that these ideas will be workable for you. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself. Have a great day. Stay blessed. Allah Hafiz.